In this tutorial, we are going to learn to prepare the first section of cash flow statement. We will take some data and try to repeat the process which is used to calculate cash flows from the operating activities of the business. So on the slide, you see some details. You have increase in profit and loss account during a financial year, transfer to general reserve, depreciation, profit on sale of fixed asset furniture, loss on sale of a fixed asset, you have preliminary expenses written off. So these are the items that are taken from a profit and loss account, profit and loss appropriation account as well. So profit and loss account details are given to you. Using these details, we will do the adjustments to the profit during the year. So and we have done this process before. This is a repetition. This is a tutorial. And then we have some more information on debtors, receivables, stock, prepaid expenses, creditors, payable, and outstanding. So these are current assets and current liabilities. So you have been given working capital details as well. And you can figure out the changes over the financial year as well. So all the information that you require has been given. You do not have an income statement given to you or a profit and loss account. You do not have a balance sheet. This is, you know, loose information provided to you. Can you prepare the cash flows resulting from the operating activities of a business? So let us attempt this problem. So this is the format and we begin with profit retained during the year. This is the increase in the profit and loss account in the balance sheet. So let me reiterate that. So in the balance sheet, you have share capital and you have reserves and surpluses. This is what we've discussed till now, the format. And this reserve and surpluses, the shareholders' funds, as we said, this can have, you know, different specific reserves in it. One of the reserves is called profit and loss account. Then you can have general reserve. You can have specific reserves. And when I'm writing specific, but there will be a name for this reserve. So after transferring all the profit, distributing all the profit to various stakeholders, whatever is left is retained in the business. And this retention is shown in the profit and loss account. So what is the increase in the profit and loss account? What is the retained earning during the year is what is shown here and what should be used in this format here. So 40,000 is the profit retained during the year, or you could call it increase in the P&L balance during the year. So profit and loss balance is not referring to the profit after tax only. This is after you do the appropriations as well. That is the point I want to drive home. All right. So this is done. Then you have, let me go to the format first. We are going to add to this profit the appropriation of profit. Why are we adding back appropriation of profit? Because dividend which is paid is not an operating item. It's not an operating expense. It's a financing expense. And the reserve, transfer to reserve, is not a cash expense, it's a non-cash expense. So I'll just mention it here for your reference. So dividend is a finance cost, is a financial activity, and reserves is a non-cash. Due to these reasons, non-cash, it's not really an expense, but it's a non-cash transaction. All right. So let us look at these the list here and accordingly pick the relevant details. Transfer to general reserve 20,000. So this 20,000 has to be added back to the increase in the profit during the year. Done. Then you have you don't have any dividends. Then straight go to depreciation, profit, preliminary expenses. All right. So these items are typically shown in the P&L, the second section of the profit and loss account. And these are the appropriation, P&L appropriation account. Alright, so nil here. Then you add non-cash expenses or non-operating expenses. Provision for tax during the year. Do we have provision for tax? No, we don't have provision. We only have depreciation to begin with. 10,000. So depreciation, 10,000. I'm going to write it here. Preliminary expenses written off is 5,000. So we're writing it here. These are non-cash. Depreciation is non-cash. Now, depreciation is an operating expense. And we are calculating profit, cash profit from operating activities. However, depreciation is non-cash. So even the operating expenses, which are non-cash expenses, we will not consider them in this section of the cash flow statement. This is done. Then you have loss on sale of machinery. This is 20,000. So loss on sale of fixed asset, 20,000 to be added. Why is this being added? Well, sale of fixed asset is not an operating item. This is an investing item. So this is investing activity. So it should not be shown. Any profit or loss resulting from sale of fixed assets is not an operating item. You should not show it here. All right, this is done. Depreciation has been taken. Now you have profit. Profit should be deducted. So profit on sale of fixed asset, the amount is 10,000. Now this profit will be shown on the credit side of the profit and loss account. It will increase the profit during the year. That means the profit for the year has been increased by 10,000 due to a non-operating income, non-operating gain which has been earned during the year. And this is also an investing activity. So we should not show it in the operating cash flow. So we are deducting it from the profit number during the year. Profit on sale of furniture is 20,000. I should write 20 here. Loss was also 20 and preliminary expenses taken care of. That's it. So in this section, in order to calculate operating cash profit, these are the items, these are the details that are with us. So using this, we will calculate the net profit, the operating cash profit before working capital changes. So this is 60, this cancels out actually. So 55 and 75. 75,000 comes out to be the cash operating profit. However, this is not the cash from all operating activities. This is only cash resulting from the activities which we have considered on this page. There are other items which are not present in the profit and loss account, and we have to consider those. What are those items? Well, those items are working capital changes. Debtors have gone up. Okay, now I need to recall the rules of current asset, current liability, increase and decrease. So if current assets go up, we consider that as an outflow. So outflow. If current assets decrease, that is an inflow. And the opposite is true for current liabilities. Outflow. Alright, so I've drawn this table on the side, and I'm just going to look at each, and mechanically using this rule, I'm going to post various these account balances. So debtors from 1819 to 1920, we have to be careful about the direction as well. So this is going up. Current asset increasing by 5,000. Current asset increasing by 5,000. This is an outflow. So this is 5,000. Increase in the current asset, 5,000 will go here. We will deduct it. This was debtors. So I'll write debtors. And next is receivables are going down. Receivables going down. Current assets are decreasing. So this is an inflow. So 2,000 inflow due to receivables. Receivables 2,000. Next up is stock. Inventory is going up by 3,000. Current asset increase is an outflow. So stock 3,000, an outflow. stock 3000 posted. Then we have prepaid expenses. These are also going up. Current asset going up. Current asset going up is an outflow 1000. 1000 prepaid expenses. All right, we are done with all the current assets now. Let's look at current liabilities. Creditors are going down by 2000. Current liability decreasing is an outflow. So 2000 creditors. Decrease in current liabilities. Next is payables. Payables are going up. Current liability going up is inflow. So 5000 payables is an inflow. And finally, you have outstanding expenses, which are also going up. Again, current liability going up. Current liability going up is an inflow. So 1000 outstanding expenses. Done. That's it. Now we have adjusted, we have made adjustments for the working capital changes. The operating cash profit before working capital changes from the previous slide, I'm just bringing it forward, 75,000, and we have to just add it or deduct it. So this is 77, 78, and 83. Out of 83, let's write it here. This is 8, 9, 10, 11,000. Deduct 11,000, you have 72. So 72,000 is the cash flows from operating activities. This is a positive number. We don't have to consider the used in the parenthesis. That's it. That's how you calculate cash flows from operating activities. One more time. You have two sections in the first section. You have two subsections. In the first subsection, you look for cash operating profit. In the second subsection, you look for the cash used in or generated from all operating activities. In the first subsection, you consider the profit during the year, and you adjust for non-cash items, non-operating items, which can be either incomes or the expenses. And then in the second section, you consider the working capital changes. That's it. I'll see you in the next video.